Welcome to the Pro 200 Series Quickstart video. Before we begin, we want to remind you of three important things. First of all, make sure that you have a dedicated power circuit for your porcelain furnace. Second of all, keep your box and packing material through the warranty period. And lastly, remember, do not turn the machine on until you're instructed to do so. All right, the first step is to open the box and remove the accessory box that's inside. The next thing to do is to tilt the box up so that you can more easily remove the machine. We've tipped the box carton and furnace up on its side so that you have better access to the machine. It's easier to remove it. Now we're going to remove the foam packing and the machine from the carton. You may need to tilt the machine back just a bit to get the bottom piece out. Now with this done, we can lift the machine out of the carton. Remember to lift from underneath the actual lift arm of the machine. And remember, it weighs about 50 pounds. Now remember, you do not want to throw away or discard the box or the packing materials. Set those aside someplace safe through the warranty period. Okay, at this point we're going to remove the shipping bar that stabilizes your lift platform during shipping. To do that, you're going to unscrew the wing nuts and remove the bolts that are caught up on the edge of the machine. Okay, remove the wing nuts on either side. And when you do, if you'll twist the bar front, it will help to dislodge the bolts. Once the bolts have been dislodged, they can be pushed up and removed. Once the bolts are out, the shipping bar can be pulled out. Please remember to retain all of these materials in case the machine needs to be shipped later. Now's a good time to open the accessory box and take inventory. Inside you'll find an extra vacuum line, a 1 gig memory stick, a magnet for writing down programs, your firing tray, a cooling tray, and your power cord. This accessory box is also a great place to store your shipping bar. Now it's time to remove the pump from the pump box. You'll notice that the pump is secured to the bottom of the box with a shipping board. That shipping board and the remainder of the shipping materials should be saved through the warranty period of the pump. With the pump removed from its shipping box, you'll notice there's an extra piece of pump hose or vacuum hose, and then the pump itself is shrink wrapped to the shipping board. You can use a knife to remove the shrink wrap. and free your pump from the shipping board. Remember to save these shipping materials with your box. At this point, you're going to remove the protective covering from the vacuum barb and install the pink vacuum tube onto the barb. The Pro 200 series furnaces have a quick cool jet. In order to use that feature, you're going to have to remove the muffler on your vacuum pump. To do this, simply untwist. In your accessory kit, a new hose, barb, and vacuum line came with the system. To install this hose barb, please use some Teflon tape on the threading, and then a crescent wrench to tighten the fitting into your vacuum pump. With the vacuum line barb installed, now you can press the vacuum line onto the barb. Now we're going to go to the back side of the porcelain furnace. All right, at this point, let's review the connections on your Pro 200 series furnaces. The first one you'll notice is the quick cool jet connection. Then there's the connector for the power supply on your vacuum. There's the vacuum pump connector. There's also on the Pro 200 a connection for an argon supply if you're firing titanium. On this side of the furnace, you have your fuses, the power supply connection, and your on and off switch. Now we're going to connect the vacuum tube lines. The pink line, which has the ingoing arrow on the top, will go to the vacuum pump barb on the back of the machine. The clear tube, which has the outgoing arrow on the top of the pump, will be connected to the quick cool jet. The next thing to connect is your power supply cord. Now your vacuum pump is completely connected. The next connection is the power supply cord for the porcelain furnace itself. This can now be connected to your power supply. Remember that for the best operation of your porcelain furnace, it should be connected to a dedicated power supply. It's now safe to turn the power on to your Pro 200 series furnace. Remember that the power switch is located at the back right-hand side of your furnace near the power supply connection. When you turn on the switch, the furnace will run through a series of self-diagnostics. After those self-diagnostics are done, the firing table will lower and you can remove the green paper that is attached. Now with the lift table down, it's time to place the firing tray on the lift table. Center the firing table with the hole over the pin in the lift table. Now it's time to program the machine. Now that the Pro 200 series furnace has done its diagnostics, you're ready to enter the first of your programs. But before we do that, we want to set three essential preferences in the special functions menu. The first is the vacuum pump, whether you're going to run it consistently or intermittently. The second is the temperature that you're going to fire in. Those units will be Celsius or centigrade or Fahrenheit. And the third is the muffle idle temperature. Now that you've arrived at the special functions menu, the first thing that you're going to want to do is to determine whether your machine will operate in units of Celsius or Fahrenheit. In order to arrive there, you need to turn the selector knob to the second special functions screen. To where the cursor says temperature in C or F. To get to the special functions menu, rotate the selector knob until the cursor arrives at the special functions menu. Then press the selector knob to enter. Now that you've determined whether your machine will run in degrees Fahrenheit or degrees Celsius, you're ready to change the idle temperature. Rotate the selector knob until you arrive with the cursor at the change idle temperature line and press enter. You can now set the new idle temperature simply by rotating the selector knob. When you've arrived at the correct idle temperature, press the selector knob, and that will set the temperature. Now we need to select whether or not the vacuum will be intermittent or constant. To arrive there, you'll need to go to Special Functions Screen 3. Rotate the selector knob until the cursor points at constant vacuum pump. Press Enter. And then answer the question, do you want constant vacuum pump? No or yes? If you'd like to have the vacuum run only until it draws the correct amount of vacuum, and then run intermittently if there's a vacuum loss, then simply turn the dial to no. If you'd like the pump to run continuously, you would turn the dial to yes and press the selector knob to enter. Now that you have set your preferences, it's time to enter your first program. From the main menu, move the selector knob until it says Change Program and press to enter. Now it will ask you to select an item. What you're going to do is to add or edit a program. Rotate the selector knob to this line and then press enter. This is program number one. We're going to press the knob to continue. The Pro 200 series furnaces allow you to run either a single stage or a dual stage in your programs. You need to select whether you're going to run that one stage or two stage firing type. When you determine which stage you're going to run, press the selector knob to enter. Now to enter the name of the program, the cursor will show up underneath a letter. In order to change the letter, rotate the selector knob until the correct letter is visible. When the correct letter is visible for the first letter in the program name, then simply press the next button to arrive at the next position and rotate the selector knob until you've arrived at the letter you wish. Continue to do this until you have named your program. With the program named, now press Enter. This will take you to the first parameter of the program, which is dry time. This dry time and all the remaining porcelain parameters should be in accordance with your porcelain manufacturer's directions. In order to change the existing dry time, simply rotate the wheel until you have arrived at the correct dry time for your porcelain and then press enter. This will take you to the next parameter, which is the entry temperature. That temperature should be set according to your porcelain manufacturer's recommendations. When you've arrived at the correct temperature, press the knob to enter. This takes you to the rate rise. This is how many degrees per minute the porcelain furnace will increase in temperature. This, once again, should be set according to your porcelain manufacturer's recommendations. When you've arrived at the correct temperature by rotating the wheel, press Enter. Now you're going to set the hold temperature. Once again, rotate the wheel until you've arrived at the correct temperature and then press the knob to enter. Now you will set the hold time. Rotate the selector until you've reached the correct time and press to enter. The machine will now ask you if you need to enter a fuse adjust. Fuse adjustments are covered in the manual. You can change this either yes or no by rotating the wheel. Then press to enter. You'll now enter the temperature that the table is to come down. Once again, rotate the wheel until you arrive at the correct temperature and press enter. Now you enter the cool time. When you arrive at the correct time, press enter. The machine will now ask you if you want to use vacuum or not. If you wish to not use vacuum, rotate the wheel so that it says no and press enter. If you prefer to use vacuum, rotate the wheel until it says yes and press enter. The Pro 200 series will now ask you which vacuum level you would like to achieve. Rotate your wheel and press enter. Now we've arrived back at the screen that allows us to start the vacuum and where we wish to start the vacuum. We can start it at rate rise. We can start it at hold time. When you decide which parameter you would like, press the enter. Now you have the ability to change the temperature during the rate rise. If you'd like to change that temperature, rotate the selector knob and press enter when you arrive at the correct temperature. Now we determine whether we release the vacuum during rate rise, during hold time, or when the table opens. When you've made your selection, press to enter. The machine now updates the information and you are ready to run the program. To run the program you've just entered, make sure from the main menu you place the cursor on Run Program, then press the selector knob to begin your program. Press the selector knob again. Your machine will now fire the program that you have selected. One of the new features of the Pro 200 series furnaces is the use of a USB port and a memory stick that's included with your Pro 200 accessories. Along with the use of the Pro 200 Master Suite, you're able to add, edit, delete, print, and transfer programs that already exist. Through the use of this USB port and the memory stick in the Special Functions program, you can go to Export or Import Programs or Export or Import Settings. This concludes the Quickstart video for the Pro 200 series of porcelain furnaces. For further information regarding your furnace, please refer to the user manual found in the accessory box.